You have a new an album with the George Shearing Quintet. I was a great fan of George Shearing when I was a young boy, when I was, what, 14, 15. And once in New York, I think in 82, he was playing in a place. It wasn't one of the traditional jazz places.
Right.
Only him and a bass player.
Mm-hmm.
And I went there, and it was so sad because it was almost empty. The place was almost empty. And I said, man, this guy is one of the marvels in the history of jazz.
Yeah.
And of course, he didn't notice because he's blind. So
right.
He noticed only, yeah, he noticed it only because of the noise that wasn't
so there. Much.
But it was a little sad, and he was great. He's still, it's fantastic.
Yeah. He's 82 years old.
82 years.
He's, you know, there's only so many musicians who they actually name a style after, you know, when
yeah.
you think of
yeah.
Count Basie piano, you know what kind of piano is when you hear George Shearing style
yeah.
is a definite yeah. something. And he's
Errol
just
Garner.
Errol Garner, you know what you're going to hear, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
Oscar Peterson,
yeah.
you know, same
exactly.
kind of thing.
And he's really fantastic. How did you come up with this idea to make this?
Well, the record company suggested it because he's George is on the Telarc label with us. So they said, would you like to make a record with George? And I asked Ray and Martin, and they let me do it. They gave me permission, just, you know. They let me off.
They did?
Yeah.
How generous of them. your father played with George Shearing?
Yep. My father was in the quintet in 81 for about 5 weeks. They opened for Frank Sinatra with the quintet. So the first hour was George Shearing Quintet, and then the rest of the show was Frank Sinatra. So
fantastic.
That was pretty good.
Do you recognize this tune? Solta em cima, por favor.
Marky Markowitz.
Pode tirar. Who's on the guitar there?
That's Bucky Pizzarelli. That's
yeah,
my
that's
father on
Bucky
guitar.
Bucky Pizzarelli.
Wow, Songs of the Apple.
Yeah,
that's an old record.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Give me this.
I love it.
Let's see.
You have it?
I had it when it was a record.
Yeah.
Before it went to CD. That was... It's Slam Stewart, I think, on
yeah.
George DeVivier on bass on that cut, and then Slam
yeah.
does a couple other things.
Yeah, and
that's
this
a great
one,
record.
And you have it on
disc,
on record.
No, I have it on record at home.
Yeah, but it's still working.
Still working, almost. Well, no, Ray gave me a turntable for my birthday a couple of years ago.
Okay, here.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
So hard for me to do that, you know, because I love this.
Well,
I love this album. No, really, really. And I said, no, John is going to go on the show. I'm going to give it to him.
Thank you very much.
You liked it?
Yes, I do very much. Thank you.
I loved it. It's an incredible, and the idea is great. Right?
All New York songs.
All the New York songs.
Yeah.
I made a copy for me before I give it to you. And what happens when you meet Brazilian people in New York?
Oh, in New York, I always go to, I always mention your name, first thing.
I say,
I go to Brazil all the time, and I say, you know, Joe Suarez. They say, oh, Joe Suarez.
Come on.
All the time. They all know who you are. And so, on the corner, there's a corner bar that I go to for hamburgers every night for dinner, and there's a kid there from Brazil who just moved there last August. And so I always see him, I always say, tudo bom, tudo bem? And he always, tudo bom.
And I say,
Joe Suarez, he goes, Joe Suarez. He's very happy about it.
Where's that bar? Where
90 and 3rd, 90th and 3rd Avenue in New York City. And this one kid, he's a big, he just loves the fact that I said, I'm going to Brazil. He says, say hello to Brazil for me. He's going to school in New York, so he's wanted me to say hello to Brazil for him, you know.
Okay, hello Brazil.
Yeah.
And tell me, John, you live nearby there?
I live 90 and Lex. I'm a block away from that bar, yeah. That's a fun little spot, Upper East Side of New York.
Do you perform a lot in New York, New York City?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, when we go back home, we'll do 4 weeks at a place called Feinstein's at the Regency Hotel. Which is, and then in September, we do four nights at Birdland.
Great.
Great jazz club.
Great. Yeah. Birdland, a tradition in itself.
Yeah, Lullaby of Birdland.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is sure. George Shearing's number.
I found a very great spot in Harlem called Lucy's. You've been to?
I've never been to Lucy's, but I've heard of it.
It's fantastic. Every Monday,
yeah,
a lot of musicians go there. They have a band, Renaissance. Mm-hmm. Jazz band, and we enjoy it so much. You've been there, yeah.
Semana passada.
Você teve lá?
Muito legal.
And there is a musician, a friend of us, that goes there all the time, Winston Bird, who plays the horn.
With T.S. Monk.
Yeah, and Monk, Monk Jr. goes there a lot too. So they introduced me to the place, and it's a lovely place to be, a lovely place to go. In this album, do you also sing? Do you only play? How is it?
No, I sing on all the cuts, and the quintet accompanies me. So we did a lot of songs that George had done over the years. George has recorded with everybody: Peggy Lee, Mel Torme, Joe Williams, Nancy Wilson. So we did a couple of songs, and Nat King Cole. So we did things that they had done on those records, and we did some new songs too.
And how much did they get to let you off?
I gave an extra 50 reals each.
That's okay. That's not bad. Not bad.
It's a good group.
How's the baby? Is it a boy or a girl?
It's a girl.
What's her name?
Her name is Lauren. And she's going to turn a year old on May the 12th. So I came
to Brazil. Now, May the 12th, and you're going to be here.
I'm going to be here.
Great. She sings already?
She does. She plays the piano already.
You're kidding me.
I'm not kidding you. She does.
Well, he was playing when he was in St. Louis as a kid. He played piano at 8 or 9. He actually has a cassette of him playing with Dizzy Gillespie. How old were you when you played with Dizzy?
13.
13 playing with Dizzy Gillespie.
His father got him to sit in and play Night in Tunisia with Dizzy Gillespie. And he's got a tape of it. It's great. So he's a freak of nature. He's been, you know,
that's a virus. That's not that's a virus. So the kid, the baby must play the piano. Also,
that's right.
You know? Mm-hmm. She inherited.
Has to do it.
How long you and your brother have been playing together for? What, 10 years? You said.
10 years with the group, with Ray too, and he's been. We played together in high school, so we've been like almost 30 years.
You're still a great fan of Brazilian music.
Oh yeah, we always talk about it. I do two in-stores, I'm going to play like in record stores to promote the record. And I get to go look at all the Brazilian records that I don't have over the years. Last time I got a good one, there's a guitar player named Marco Pereira, who's a great guitar player.
Marco Pereira?
Pereira?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're all nodding.
Yeah.
And great.
If they don't nod, they're fired. That's so they just nod in and they don't know they.
But it's a great, it's great to find these records. And I found some João Bosco record that I didn't have. And and Milton Nascimento came to see us in Rio 2 times ago. So that was a big honor for us, too.
Milton Nascimento was there.
It's a great
What's the latest Brazilian tune or song that you got on your guitar?
You know, I never played Ipanema for you. I could always play Ipanema. Sure, I played Gingy last time, I think.
Yeah, play Ipanema for us.
Tall and tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, each one she passes goes on. When she walks just like a samba that sways so cool and swings so gentle, that when she passes, each one she passes goes on. How I watch her so sadly. How can I tell her I love her? Yes, I would give my heart gladly. But each day as she walks to the sea, she looks straight ahead, not at me. Tall and tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking in. When she passes, I smile, but she doesn't see.
And you sing it in Portuguese too?
No, you know, when we play the song live, at the end of all of our concerts here, I do one chorus in English, then the audience sings it in Portuguese. Happens everywhere we go. It's the most magical thing.
That's great. You sing the first one
in English, because they speak better Portuguese than I do. So.
Oh, well, but you speak better in English.
That's right.
So it's perfect match. Perfect match. What style? I'm a great fan of this record of your father. He had a lot of influence in the way you play.
Oh yeah. Well, you know, in our house, if you see the way this guitar is on the couch, there was always a guitar on the couch like this. So every time you walked in the room, you'd see the guitar. You'd have to pick it up and play it. You know, so you never had to take it out of the case. So that's how I learned how to play. I'd always find the guitar on the couch, pick it up, play a couple notes, and then my father'd poke his head out and look at me, and he'd say, "No, you know, not that chord. G7, you know, yell a chord out, and then it'd go away, you know."
And so, how come your brother went to the bass? Because he was greedy. He wanted a bigger.
Well, we had enough guitar players in the family, so we made him a bass player. You know,
that's good.
We needed a bass player.
Okay, let's hear John Pizzarelli. What are you gonna do first?
We're gonna play "Shine on Your Shoes."
Shine on Your Shoes, John Pizzarelli with the John Pizzarelli Trio.
Sure. I love you, cats. There
we go. When you feel as low as the bottom of a well and you can't get out of the mood, do something to pick yourself up and change your attitude. I'll give a tug to your tie, put a crease in your pants. But if you really want to feel fine, give your shoes a shine. When there's a shine on your shoes and a melody in your heart with a singable happy feeling, what a wonderful place to start to face the world every day with a dee-dum-dee-di-di, a little melody that is making the worrying world go by. When you walk down the street with a happy-go-lucky beat, you'll find a lot in what I'm repeating. When there's a shine on your shoes and a melody in your heart, what a wonderful way to start the day. Start.
Yes, another one.
Okay. It's not a problem.
It's small.
Okay. Sure.
John Pizzarelli, mais um. Let's hear it.
One, two, three.
If dreams come true, I'll be with you. I love that smile in your eyes. You seem a dream in disguise. In your caress, I find happiness and love. If dreams come true, Ray Kennedy.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Muito obrigado. Daqui a pouco a gente volta. Uou! Eu vou conversar com o psiquiatra.